The Transportation Department reveals plans for a cable car system that would connect the planned MRT 4 station in Taytay, Rizal to Antipolo City. The agency says the decision is a result of a pre-feasibility study funded by the Asian Development Bank in the first quarter of the year. The DOTR notes, though, a more detailed study is still needed to determine how many passengers will actually benefit from the urban cable car and how much the project would cost. If approved, the agency says it may conduct a solicited proposal for the project, which may be bid out by 2026. Now, last month, DOTR Secretary Jimmy Bautista said he already gave a go signal for the conduct of a feasibility study on installing self-driving cable cars in Baguio City. The construction of the $2.1 billion Bataan-Cavite Interlink Bridge has been pushed back for a second time to the year 2025. The Public Works and Highways citing funding issues is the reason for the delay. The more than 32-kilometer bridge was initially projected to begin late last year but was postponed to early or mid-2024 as the DPWH was still finalizing financing arrangements with the Asian Development Bank. The bridge is expected to cut travel time between Cavite and Bataan to around 45 minutes from 5 hours at present. Once completed, it would become the longest bridge in the country, surpassing the 8.9-kilometer Cebu-Cordova Bridge. Now, a 1 billion peso fund aimed at helping the construction and rehabilitation of green open spaces, including public and municipal parks across the Philippines, launched by the Philippine government. The budget department says the local government support fund, that's Green 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 program, covers 80 local government units benefiting 38 cities and municipalities in Luzon, 21 in Visayas, and 21 in Mindanao. Affected LGUs can also use the fund to bankroll projects creating bike lanes, elevated or at-grade pedestrian footpaths, walkways, sports facilities, among others. The DBM launched the program in collaboration with the MMDA on Wednesday in Pasay City. The Philippine government now crafting policies for the safe use of nuclear power as Manila's civil nuclear cooperation deal with Washington takes effect. But this has failed to soothe the nerves of environmental groups. Alvin Olchico tells us why.
While the Philippines is not expected to see a new nuclear facility until year 2029 or 2030, this early, the government is already paving the way for the next administration to have regulatory framework that will ensure a safe and secure nuclear industry. The 123 agreement signed by both U.S. and Philippine officials last year has commenced July 2. It will allow the export of nuclear technology and equipment from the U.S. to the Philippines. Energy Secretary Rafael Otilia says the job now is to ensure that policies are set for the safe use of nuclear and to boost its social acceptance among host communities.
As far as the government is concerned, any technology carries risks. And therefore, the thing to do is to minimize and to manage to control those sources of risks.
While the DOE is looking at small modular reactors, the head of the Philippine Nuclear Research Institute says it will be quicker to reopen the Bataan nuclear power plant after a thorough study by experts.
Huwag ahadlangin dahil sa political or vested interest. Yan po kasi ang kasi krimen niyan sa palagay ko. Kasi nangangailangan yung mga tao eh. Nag-survey po ang DOE in 2019. 79% ng mga taong bayan ay paboro sa nuklear kasi sobrang mahal ng kuryente.
According to Arcilia, the PNRI has been storing nuclear fuel since the 1960s for academic and training purposes, which proves that Filipino experts have the capacity to ensure safety of the facility.
May nagsabi po sa akin, di mo mga mapaandar yung mga tren mo, mag-ambisyon ko pa ng nuklear. Ang sagot ko po dyan ganito, ang eroplano, a jet engine, is far more complicated than a nuclear power plant. Sino nagmamaintain ng mga jets natin? Mga Filipino technicians. It's an insult to say na hindi natin kaya.
But environment protection group Greenpeace worries about potential disasters that nuclear reactors can cause.
Since archipelagic tayo, any incident that involves sa dagat ay pwede pa siya mag-expand. At kung nuclear ito, nuclear incident to, imagine na lang anong pwede mangyari sa atin. Ba't pa tayo gagamit ng nuclear kung meron tayong mga energy resources na pwede na nating gamitin dito na mas mura, mas safe, no, at mas reliable.
Greenpeace insists the Philippines can instead focus on abundant and cleaner renewable energy sources with minimal risk on the environment. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
The National University, or NU, aims to establish 20 campuses across the Philippines by 2028, with locations in Bacolod, Las Piñas, and Cebu already set to open in the next 2 years. To date, NU has 11 campuses with a population of 55,000 students. The SM Group backed university says this proves their commitment to providing quality, accessible, and affordable education to the Filipino people. It adds the move reflects their goal of boosting the workforce in industries like engineering, accounting, and IT to meet regional demands. The Philippine government also offering a high-tech future for Philippine small retailers running the so-called Savvy Savvy stores. The Science and Technology Department is allotting 3.5 million pesos to fund Filipina startup Packworks, which offers a business-to-business or B2B fast-moving consumer goods marketplace for Savvy Savvy stores. The fund will support Packworks' development of a machine learning powered precision marketing model, which will offer Savvy Savvy stores customized recommendations on sellable items and promotions. The feature will be launched as an in-app service on the startup Savvy Savvy Store.ph Pro app and is expected to benefit its network of over 270,000 stores nationwide. Savvy Savvy stores are part of micro, small, and medium-sized enterprises in the Philippines, which account for an overwhelming 99.5% of all business establishments. Buying makeup can sometimes be a hit or miss affair. A South Korean cosmetics giant, though, is taking the pain out of finding the right shade using a robot and artificial intelligence. Take a look.
Struggle to find cosmetic products in the right shade? This AI-powered technology can help. The robot made by South Korean cosmetics giant Amor Pacific is able to analyze users' skin and create products tailored to their exact needs on the spot.
Initially, I didn't fully trust it, but after applying it to my lips, I found it suited me well, so I believe it's trustworthy.
In South Korea's capital of Seoul, this AI-powered makeup manufacturer scans skin using data gathered over 78 years of the company's history, Amor Pacific has said. The robot then recommends products from a range of some 205 different skin foundation shades and 366 different lip product colors. Lee Young Jin is an advisor at Amor Pacific.
Initially, AI technology is applied to diagnose customers' skin conditions and recommend existing products based on their needs. Beyond that, for more segmented customer needs, we offer a service that allows customers to try the recommended colors and then make customized products on site.
Kwon Yu Jin was recommended a new foundation shade thanks to AI.
Everyone has their own specific skin tone, but usually buy the most common color available over the counter. Even though I'm interested in cosmetics, it's not easy to analyze them myself, and it's hard to tell just by looking. But with AI analyzing them for me, it seems more accurate.
Traditionally, cosmetics were chosen through brand recognition, packaging, reviews, and store staff recommendations. But that can offer limited options and often falls short of meeting individual needs or skin conditions. Now the market for using AI in beauty and cosmetics industries is forecast to more than double, from over $3.2 billion in 2023 to $8.1 billion in 2028. That's according to analyst provider Business Research Company. This is expected as services expand, including personalized beauty recommendations, virtual makeup artists, and skin analysis and diagnostics. Yang Yong-suk is a principal researcher at South Korea's Electronics and Telecommunications Research Institute.
If the existing method allowed for the release of a new cosmetic product every 2 months, incorporating this AI technology could enable the release of a new product every week. Combining AI technologies could lower hurdles for cosmetics further because robots and AI would make the decisions and continuously produce new products instead of humans.